In this exercise, we're going to create a graphic that allows the backplate to grow as we type in the text box. And not only will the backplate grow, but we're going to add an extra element that's going to follow the text or the backplate as it does grow. So to show you an example of what we're going to be doing here, I have a scene set up. And when I come into my text editor here and I type, you can see how this box grows. So as we keep typing our letters in here, the backplate grows. And not only does the backplate grow, but also the green box to the right also follows the backplate or the text as I type. So we're going to set this scene up here. And there's actually two primitives that we'll use and a font. So I'm going to create a new scene here. And we'll just call this follow or something like that. You can call it whatever you want. And I have a blank scene here. So the first thing that I'm going to do is just drag a group down. You don't necessarily need to do that, but I like to stack everything within a group. And then I'm going to find a font first of all. So I'm just going to navigate to my font folder and drag a font down into this group. Now I also want to use a rectangle. So I'm going to drag a rectangle down. You could use pretty much any geometry you want. But for this purpose, I'll just be using a rectangle to keep it somewhat simple. And I'm going to first move my rectangle down in the Y position to position it down and to the left of the lower third part of the screen. And maybe I'll just adjust the height of my rectangle to about 50. I'm also going to place my font over top of it. So I'll also position this left and down. And I'm going to bring it up once in Z-scale. Now I could place any type of material or image on my rectangle, but I'm just going to keep it simple here, and I'm just going to use the built-in color generator of the rectangle here and use the colors within the rectangle itself. So now I have a green rectangle here, and this is going to be our backplate. I could color my font as well, so if you're having a hard time seeing them, I'm going to drop a material on that as well, just so maybe we'll be able to see it a little bit better, and I'll just darken this up a bit to black. And now I need to create the ability for my backplate or my rectangle to grow as I type in my text box. To do this, I'm going to go into the built-ins and into the function plugins tab or FP tab, and I'm going to navigate down here to the tools folder, and I have this plugin here called TextBG, and I'm going to drag this onto the rectangle. And if you don't know which container to always drag it onto, it's okay, you just have to experiment sometimes. So when I do drag this onto this rectangle, you see how the rectangle automatically conforms to the size of the font. And I'm going to come into my TextBG function, and into the editor here, we have a couple of things that we need to set up. So number one, our size parameter. Do I want it to go width and height? Well, that's okay, but I'm really just concerned about the scale. So I'm going to go to scale and change it to scale. The text container refers to which container the text is. Is it the previous container or the parent? Well, right now it's the previous container, and I'm just going to leave it to the previous container. If we had it set to parent container, we would need to drag this inside of that text container. But I'm just going to leave it as is and have it set to previous. We need to tell it which direction we're concerned with. We're only concerned with it growing on the X scale, so I'm going to change this to X. We also have a hide on empty button, which I'm going to leave on now. And it just means that if we have no text within our text editor, this green rectangle is going to be hidden. You also have a right margin, which I'm going to increase or decrease a little bit. I'm just going to set this at 5 to increase or to decrease our margins. There's also a lock margins. We can turn this off and adjust each margin individually if need be. I'll keep it on locked for now. So when I come into my text now and I type in here, you can see how this box now grows with the type. And it did reset our height a little bit, so if you needed to readjust the height, we could come back into the rectangle editor and adjust the height a little bit if you want. Now, the next step will be to add another type of primitive so that we can have it follow this text or backplate as well. And I'm just going to use a rectangle again. So I'm just going to make it a blue color, and I'm just going to select blue and drag this down on every square. Now we have a blue rectangle. And I'm going to stay within the rectangle editor and just adjust the width a little bit, and then I'm going to jump back into the transform editor and just readjust this a little bit. Now it won't matter too much where we set this at the moment, because as you'll see when we add the next function onto this rectangle, it's going to reset it or reposition it anyway. So I'm going to go into my built-ins, my FP tab, and this time we're going to use a function called auto follow. So I'm going to drag this auto follow down onto my blue rectangle. When I did that, it readjusted a little bit. I'm going to click on my auto follow and go into my auto follow editor. And a couple things that we have to worry about here. Number one being the direction. Now we have our direction set to X. So I'm going to leave it at X because I want it to go left or right and grow on the X scale with my font and my green rectangle. We also have option here for our reference container, and it gives us a choice between previous, first, or other. Previous may work since it will follow this rectangle, but I'm going to click on other here, and when we do that, it opens up this other container box. Whenever you see a box like this, it's waiting for some type of container, so I'm going to drag this Arial bold font or text container into this box here. And when we did that, it automatically adjusted it. Two other options that we need to be aware of. X local center refers to the center point of our rectangle. It's not a huge deal in this case, and it's set to left by default. So I'm just going to change it to center. And when we do this, you're going to see it readjust a little bit again. And then we need to worry about the X previous center. X previous center refers to the container that it is following. In this case, it's our text. And even though it's not our immediate previous container, we did drag it into the other container box here, and that's what it's referring to. So our X previous center is set to left. I'm just going to leave it on there. If you really need to double check it, you can come into your transform editor or set it to left right here if you want to be extra careful. So now I'm just going to concern myself with the default distance here, and if I adjust this a little bit, I can close that gap or leave a gap, however you wish. So now that we come back into our text editor, and as we start to type in here again, you're going to see how that blue bar now follows it.